But I wasn't Coach Day because it was like immediately after he like named Coach Day as the offensive coordinator, and Coach Day had been the offensive, or not the offensive coordinator, but an offensive coach for 2 years while I'd been there. So I had some familiarity there, and then after I met him, I was a good guy, Coach Nazo.
Depth-wise, we're not so great, but we have a bunch of guys
different really
some progress.
What did he tell you in that first meeting that maybe calmed your concerns?
I just remember him in the press conference giving me some praise and saying that we definitely had a quarterback that we think we can build off of. So obviously that makes you feel great. You don't really even know the person yet. He's already complimenting you on certain things. So that was definitely nice.
I'm sure, like, the first thing, whenever there's a coaching change, is how is this going to affect me as a player?
I mean, I think it does make a difference.
Systems,
when you have how smarter players, you kind of...
Yeah, the system is, everyone usually has a hard to go through. This is my fifth system in 3.5 years, played as a true freshman, so it's not the most ideal situation, but you got to approach the game like a professional. You're 20, all these guys are 20, 21, 22 years old, and... it hasn't been hard for me to adjust any of the systems. I just pick them up.
So what did you
I learn them.
And just tell me.
You got to be confident about it because you have guys that are younger with less experience around you, and you have to teach them essentially. You have to be an extension of the coach. So it hasn't been a problem for me adjusting at all. It's just another. It's more information you end up knowing. It'll help you in the future.
Yeah, I guess having the experience of learning new systems along the way can't really hurt the fact that you've already been there.
Definitely.
I mean, how much different is it? I mean, is it a very, very different system?
It's all like, with all the different systems, this is the fifth one. Conceptually, all offenses have similar plays, just terminology is different. So right now we're working on, getting more fluent with all the calls and terminology, signals, and it's not too much different. It kind of is everything that we've done so far, kind of a mixture. And then it's all, most plays in a game, unless you're in Oregon, where you're like a fast-paced every play like that, most teams want to have like a balanced running game or a passing game. And it's situational football, so it's their choice about running the football. We have different things, we have different plays and different concepts for different situations.
Chase, I saw Steve Logan. Former offensive coordinator. He's probably the one guy you haven't had as an offensive coordinator.
actually, him and Coach Martin, last coordinator, coached at ECU together. So his offense is kind of an extension of Steve's, and so I got to learn some of the terminology and such concepts that Steve wanted to use. Obviously, they're really successful at UFBC.
It's quite a turnover. How many guys now?
This is my fifth coordinator.
Did you say call him Steve? Adagio?
No, we were talking about Steve. Oh, so you're talking about Steve Logan.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Steve Logan, So, fifth guy in 3.5 years. The roster included to begin with was. Who were the guys that?
Oh, it was. So we had Gary Tranquil. Then we had Kevin Rogers. Then Dave Brock. Then
how long has she been
Coach Martin?
She was there for 2 years. Was the third year that you could go?
Close to.
Yeah.
Is she how does he differ from all the guys?
It's kind of. It's conceptually like all everything is a lot of offenses across the nation are all similar, but you just call them different names, different terminology for it. So in that sense, it's different. Every offense is different. Some of the protections have carried over from different offenses that we've had. Some of the pass plays have carried over from different offenses that we had, just because they're so universal around the country. So for me, it's just. You gotta learn it all and you gotta be confident with it. So the rest of the guys that have less experience aren't watching as much film as you. Maybe don't know really how to approach the game yet. Like you're supposed to. Major college football. I can help them understand the plays better on the field.
Did the nomenclature change much from Tranquil on down to Coach Day, and has it been difficult to kind of settle into a system that's been constantly changing?
Like, ideally, you don't want to have five coordinators in 3.5 years. Obviously,
you get all worked out.
You'd like to have some consistency just so you can really start to master an offense, but you got to take away from it that you're also learning new systems. Like, knowledge of the game is expanding. And if anything, it's just something, like I said, you just got to learn it, and then you got to help the rest of your guys learn it faster, because when you're a quarterback, there's so much terminology, there's so much conceptuality that you're around it so much that you process everything faster than the rest of the guys around you. And you need to help the receivers, the offensive line, tight ends, the running backs get to the right spots, because they might be thinking something from a previous offense, but you got to be on top of it. And that is the last quarter.